Austin Lewis joins Cage Minds, preparing for King of the Cage Willpower. First off, how are you feeling, sir?
Pretty good. How are you?
I'm doing well. We're seeing you back in the cage. It's been a couple months. What have you been working on?
A lot of stand-up. Been working my ground game, just a little bit of everything. That's part.
Coming out of the last fight, last time we saw you in the cage, Ambrose Vigil. He was a guy making his debut. How difficult was that to deal with a guy that you had never seen before, didn't know what to expect?
Not really difficult at all, because when we fight out here at the Battlegrounds, you don't really know who your opponent is till the day of the weigh-in, so it's not really difficult on that part, but he was a pretty tough opponent for being his first fight.
And now, not even really a local guy, they're bringing a dude down from Colorado to face you here at King of the Cage. What do you know about Jose?
I know he's a stand-up fighter. I don't know if he's a kickboxer or whatnot, but his record is 2-1, and he's from Colorado, and that's all I know for now. He's 5'7". So.
And then what are you worrying about for this fight?
Nothing. We're just going to go in and fight. Let's go.
And where have you been worried? What has your thought process been on trying to improve? You've been wanting to improve everywhere, but there's been like a specific game plan to what you've been doing?
I've been working a lot on my boxing because I need to start throwing my hands a lot more because I kind of hesitate in the fights a little bit, so I've been working my boxing a lot, and then like my jits and stuff, so.
And then talking about the boxing, we know you've been getting touched up by some really high caliber guys, so you got to be getting more comfortable. What's that training been like?
Oh, it's amazing. Like, they're helping me get better every day. Every time I go step in the ring with them, helps me get better. And
who are the guys that have been helping you get better?
Matthew Griego, and there's a couple that we go spar every once in a while. They're Angel and Ilham Perez.
So for you, an MMA fighter, we know you love your Muay Thai. What's it like getting in there and really mixing it up with the boxers that focus boxing all the time?
At first, it's kind of overwhelming because, of course, they're better with their hands. But over time, you learn how to move and get away from their hands, so just at first it's a little overwhelming.
Battlegrounds, King of the Cage, how used to the bright lights, performing in front of a crowd, and going through the, you know, from the weigh-ins to the getting ready to the mental preparation, how do you feel you're acclimating to getting ready to everything, you know, that goes along with coming with the fight game?
Mentally, I don't know, it's crazy. All of us have got something messed up in our heads because we like to fight. It's kind of weird, but it is what it is.
What's the moment like for you when they tell you you're up next and your music hits?
You get a crazy adrenaline rush, and like, I don't know, it's like a feeling you can't really explain, but like you get like nervous, you get amped up, and you just like, you get ready, and then like as you get closer to the ring, you just get in the zone and you're just ready.
You're in that cage, you're in that ring. Do you hear anything but the coaches? Is it just like a lot of muffledness going on? What are those like, those other senses when you're in there trying to concentrate and focus on fighting?
I hear my coaches like through everything, but you do hear like, if you land a good shot, you hear the crowd go crazy. Like you can hear the screaming, but you can't hear like certain individuals saying stuff like, but you can.
Like the guy in the third row that thinks he's telling you what's going on, you ain't got no clue what he was talking about, right?
Oh, no, he like, no. They think you do, but no. Yeah.
This journey, how you're progressing as a martial artist, how do you feel about it?
It's coming by quick. It's fun, but I don't want to rush into going pro too quick because you can need all the experience you can get, so I want to stay in the amateurs for a while. Get better.
Next Saturday, what does it take to get your hand raised?
Just get in there and fight. Freaking give it my all.
Why do you love fighting?
Because it takes a team to get ready, but once you're in there, it's just yourself. It's kind of like a one-on-one sport. Like, it doesn't take a whole team to win. So to help you get ready to win, it helps if you need a team, but in that moment, it's just yourself, and I kind of like that about it, so.
And how has training martial arts helped you find how you are, who you are?
It humbles you a lot because you come in thinking you're badass and then you get beat up for a while. So, humbling.
And now how is it getting to the point where you're active as an amateur and you turn around and you're able to hand out some of those beatings?
It's cool. You still got to stay humble because there's always somebody bigger and better, so you just got to stay in the gym, train hard, and just be ready.
King of the Cage, Willpower. We'll see Austin Lewis in action. Thank you for the time, sir.
Thank you.